All right, in the last section of this chapter, 20.15, we'll look at alpha-beta unsaturated carbonyls. And what we'll find out is that alpha-beta unsaturated carbonyls react differently than either carbonyls do on their own or alkenes do on their own. So we'll have to examine how they react differently. So here we have our carbonyl, and if we want to start looking at how do we identify the positions next to the carbonyl, the one right next to it would be called alpha. If we go one space away, we would call that beta. If we keep going, we'd call this gamma. And we'd call this one delta. So when we talk about alpha-beta unsaturated carbonyls, what we're talking about is this alkene that's next to the carbonyl. Now, why is that more interesting than any other kind of carbonyl, or a beta-gamma or a gamma-delta carbonyl? And the reason has to do with the hybridization of each of these orbitals. So if I look at this oxygen, the oxygen here is sp2 hybridized with a p orbital. This carbonyl carbon is sp2 hybridized with a p orbital. This alkene carbon here is sp2 hybridized with a p orbital, and this one here is also sp2 hybridized with a p orbital. So because of that, there's a resonance structure that we can draw that shows charge separation. So that's one resonance structure that we can draw. We can also draw one where we only move the carbonyl carbon pi bond out onto the oxygen. We could leave this one here, and we move this electron pair out so that we have a positive at the carbonyl carbon and negative on oxygen. So there are three different resonance structures that we can draw here, one neutral and two with charge separation. So if I want to look at the hybrid of all the resonance forms, there would be a partial negative on oxygen, a partial positive on the carbonyl carbon, and a partial positive on the carbon in the beta position. And so that's going to be important when we start looking at the possible reactions that we can do. So there are two possible sites that are electrophilic. Those are both electrophilic. And therefore, they're possible sites for nucleophilic attack. So there are really two possibilities. We can get 1-2 addition, where the nucleophile comes in, adds to the carbonyl, pushes that electron pair out onto oxygen. And then it gets reprotonated. To recover the alcohol. So that would be a 1-2 addition. The other possibility is a 1-4 addition, or a conjugate addition, where the nucleophile adds to the end where the alkene is, or the beta end of the alpha-beta unsaturated carbonyl, pushing this electron pair over, pushing this electron pair up onto oxygen. And now we have to be careful with this mechanism, because I'll draw down here what some people are likely to do. And that is, some people are likely to say, okay, so I reprotonate my alkoxide to give me my final product. The problem is, this is not an alcohol. Up here, the product is an alcohol. The product here is an enol. And if you remember from earlier in class, enols tautomerize with ketones, and enols are typically less stable than ketones. So if I go back up to the first one, what actually happens instead is this pair of electrons comes back down to reform the carbonyl, and this pair of electrons comes out and gets protonated. And I'll draw in the new hydrogen that was added just so that you can see it. Normally you don't have to draw that in. And what we're left with is we're left with a carbonyl at the end of the 1,4 addition, or at the end of the conjugate addition. Now, what we really want to know is which molecules are going to do which reaction. And it turns out that alkyl lithium compounds and Grignards both will do 1-2 addition. They'll both add to the carbonyl directly. While Gilman reagents we'll do 1,4 addition. So again, we can use this to do what organic chemists always want to do, and that is to control everything. If we want to add to the beta position, the end of the alkene, we can do that by introducing our R group with a Gilman reagent, a dialkyl lithium cuprate. If we want to add directly to the carbonyl and keep our alkene intact, we can do that with alkyl lithium or Grignard reagents.